As we've discussed in the previous segments, the spinal cord is divided into functional units called spinal segments, and each spinal segment has a spinal nerve associated with it. Each spinal nerve projects to a specific part of the body, and when we map those specific regions to the body's surface, we call it a dermatome. And Dr. Alsup introduced the concept of a dermatome when she talked about the integumentary system. So in this slide, what it demonstrates is the fact that even simple spinal nerves in the bottom here, it's easy to see how these project to one specific area. And even when you have a plexus, as is depicted here, where the nerves come together and then separate again, it still results in a basic map on the body surface, as can be seen in this little guy. So this is a depiction of all of the dermatomes and their body map on the surface of your body. And dermatomes do overlap, so I think, and I've talked to neurologists about this, I think you need to lose probably more than one spinal nerve before that you would notice a big gap on your body surface. But if you do some really fine testing, you should be able to find that little area that doesn't have any innervation. So the dermatomes are made up of all of the dorsal root ganglion projections from one spinal level. So here's a depiction of a dorsal root ganglion, or DRG, neuron. It projects, it has its peripheral projection where it's gathering information from the skin. It's carrying information this way and then into the cell body and then back out towards the, its central process is going toward the spinal cord, toward the dorsal horn. So each dorsal root ganglion neuron innervates one square, one little bitty piece of real estate on the periphery, and this is called a cutaneous field. So one neuron, one tiny area of skin, cutaneous field. Okay? And so each dorsal root ganglion contains hundreds of dorsal root ganglion neurons. Therefore, each of these dermatomes contains multiple cutaneous fields, right? Because it's all of the neurons, all the DRG neurons associated with each spinal level is going to be reflected in each dermatome, then contains multiple cutaneous fields as represented by multiple DRG neurons. A similar kind of representation occurs within the motor system, with motor neurons, and that's demonstrated here. In that a motor unit is another definition we talk about when we're talking about the peripheral nervous system. This represents one alpha motor neuron and its axon that comes out and innervates different skeletal muscle fibers. So a motor unit is one neuron and the number of skeletal muscle fibers that it innervates. This varies greatly from region to region. So when you think about if the unit is like one neuron to 10 muscle fibers, that's very fine control. And that would be kind of an example of maybe the ratio of innervation in your forearm muscles that control your fingers, right? Very fine control there. If you've got one neuron and you've got a 1,000 muscle fibers, then I'm thinking about great big muscles that have great big kind of gross motor movements, like maybe my thigh muscles or my back muscles. I can't really move my thigh in really the same kind of fine-tuned way that I'm able to move my fingers. And so that is partially reflected in the number of motor units assigned to each of those muscles. So in summary, what I want you to understand, and from all of these brief lectures on the spinal cord and on the peripheral nerves, is what's a spinal segment? What are the modalities of the dorsal roots and the ventral roots and the spinal nerves? What is the cauda equina? I'd like you also to be able to define a dermatome, define a cutaneous field, and define a motor unit. If you can do all that, you're ready for the assessment.